counting down to first pitch at Citi Field. It's the Marlins and the Mets next on the show. MLB The Show has baseball on tap from lovely Citi Field in New York. The finale of our series and of the first half between the Miami Marlins and the New York Mets. Hi again, folks. Matt Vasgersian here to bring you this matchup of NL Eastern Division rivals. I'm joined by Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Eric, let's give the folks at home a look at what's happened in the first two games of the series.
Well, you see there, a real good ball game yesterday afternoon. Most one-run games are. I expect this one should be pretty tight, too. Both of these ball clubs really match up well together.
We'll hear plenty more from the guys moving forward, but before we do, let's have a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Miami Marlins, as their order here this afternoon will look like this. They'll go to work against a guy once involved in a deadline deal for Carlos Beltran, the electric right-hander Zach Wheeler. Christian Yelich will head for the box as we are just about ready to get things going today.
Leading off the afternoon for Miami, left fielder Christian Yelich.
And we are underway this afternoon as the first pitch is over for a called strike one.
First pitch, 1-11.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. Swing and ooh, he saws him off with that one. And he is gonna reach to start the ball game. Didn't hit it far, but it's an infield single. So it'll be scored an infield single here to start things out. And with that, let's take a look at the defense for the New York Mets. It's brought to us by Majestic. Brian Bogusevic will stand in, hoping to perhaps pick up a base hit so we can climb over that Mendoza line. Big hole on the right side. Here's the first pitch. Starts him out with a curveball for a strike. Swings under the fastball here as this is popped high in the air back behind short. Quintanilla backs up a bit and he takes charge for the first out.
Yeah, very tough to get on top of a fastball at 96. Even if you miss it by an inch or two, this is what the result will be, an easy pop-up.
Giancarlo Stanton will dig in for the first time here, looking to change his fortunes a bit as he's seen that average dip these last four or so games. First pitch on the way. Yelich is running. Pitch misses low. The throw down. Not in time as he steals second.
And later in the game, maybe you question this decision to run because you worry about taking the bat out of the hands of one of your best hitters. But here in a scoreless game, I doubt they're going to put him on. So that was a good job to take what's given to you.
And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike. For Yelich, he picks up his fifth stolen base on the campaign.
Ball
A throw behind the runner at second, just keeping him close. And this is low, but it's roped in quickly, and that runner will hold at second base. And a 2-1 slider is looked at for a called strike two. Now a ball hit pretty well to left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. And this is swung on and bounced up the center of the diamond. Throw on to Davis at first, and there's out number two.
Well, at the very least, he does move that runner up to third base. But with two away now, I don't think that's exactly what he was hoping to accomplish. I think he wanted to drive him in.
Garrett Jones will stand in now in an early RBI spot in the top of the first. They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one. Two outs here with a runner at third. Runner away from third. Now the pitch. Outside for a ball, 1-1.
Well, that's a good spot for that two-seam fastball. You know, remember, that'll run away from left-handers, so a good idea to work the outside edge.
Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Here's a swing and a ground ball, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Men on third with two down. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
Well, that might be his way of saying, look, enough of the foul balls already.
Now here's another pitch fouled off and heading for the seats, and he's just fighting to stay alive here, still 2-2. And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over. One left for Miami. And now the Mets offense will go to work for the first time. No score. Now here's the starting lineup for the Mets as put forward by manager Terry Collins. Kevin Slowey will get the ball to face them, and if you're looking for a key to this ball game, it'll be how he fares the first time or two through the order. This is a guy that can struggle in the early going, so a good start is imperative for him here. And in the field, the Marlins will align themselves like this. Eric Young Jr. will stand in now. Speed is definitely a big weapon in his arsenal. He currently sits third in the National League stolen base chase. Now he swings and hits this ball on the ground. And this is knocked down on the mound. And the recovery's a quick one as he gets his man at first. Good composure that time to record the first out of the inning.
And that's a pretty good job of staying with the ball because he doesn't really panic after he clanked it. And then he just regathers himself and fires a strike to first to get the out.
Daniel Murphy will stand in, and he was among the many who failed to record a base hit in the loss yesterday. They'll try and entice him with a high fastball, but he wouldn't commit. It's ball one.
He's going to want to keep that pitch down a little more. Day game, ball will be jumping, so you got to keep that ball in the park today.
Bases are empty, one man out. And he takes a called strike one. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1. And he gets some pretty good wood on it here as this is lifted to fairly deep left. But he's going to get there as he runs it down on the warning track for the second out of the inning.
Well, you know, he had the right idea up there, so at least you know he's thinking. He tried to go the other way with this ball, but he got under it just a little bit, and it's an easy play out there in left field.
David Wright will get his first cuts now, and he'll do so with the bases empty and two away here in the first. And now here's a ball hit pretty well out toward right center field. And Stanton will put this one away, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Mets. We've played an inning. No score. Greg Dobbs will get his first chance at it now. Didn't factor much into the win yesterday as he took an 0-for-4 in the ball game. And that one's in on the hands to start the inning. It's ball one.
Come on, guys, let's go.
And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And he's fallen behind now, 3-1.
I think that's consistent with how the strike zone gets called nowadays. You know, that's a strike in the rule book, but most umpires won't give you that pitch anymore.
Let's go, shut him down.
The 3-1 pitch. And that misses for ball four, so it's a leadoff walk here to start the second.
And remember, he's coming off a loss in his last start. So if he keeps doing things like walking the leadoff guy, he'll be in trouble here, too.
Jared Saltalamacchia will stand in for the first time now, looking to keep that hot streak going as he's been hitting the ball well these past six ball games. Now here's the first pitch. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1. in the air down the left field line and deep. Granderson ranges deep into the corner to make the catch for the first down. Adani Echevarria will take his first cuts here with the runner still at first and one away now. Fouled straight back.
That runner's leaning.
And this one's downstairs. It's a ball and a strike. Towards second. Out in front here as this is pulled down the third base line. But a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. And here's a ball lifted high into foul ground down the right field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Here he comes again, 1-2. Swing and a miss at the curveball, and there's your second out of the inning.
Well, just an excellent sequence on the mound that time, and we're going to run you right back through it right here on Show Track. Now, you're going to notice as the dots come up, the trend, pretty evident. Everything's going to be down around the knees or lower. Now, the more you can stay out of any guy's wheelhouse, the better off you're going to be, and it worked perfectly right here.
Jordani Valdespin. We'll get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. There's a fastball missing down and away for a ball, 1-0. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's 1-1. One pitch, a curveball that's right there. One ball, two strikes.
Now you can't look for a specific pitch. You just got to protect the plate.
To two balls and two strikes now.
You see right there on the graphic, these first two innings have been costly pitch-wise. He's at 35 already, and he's only through an inning and two-thirds.
Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, but this is back into the seats, a foul ball. Now another 2-2. Trying to nibble here, and he misses to run it full now, 3-2.
And now 3-2, two out. He'll be helped by the fact that that runner will get a head start out there.
Now a ball hit in the air, but in play perhaps down the line, and they can't run it down. A payoff pitch one more time, and a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four, and as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
Oh, and you know he wanted that one. Now the inning will continue, and a guy moves up into scoring position here.
Kevin Slowey will get a shot now with two on and two out here in inning number two.
Focus that batter.
And that's cut on and missed, 0-1.
Good pitch right there, right on the heels of a walk. He needed to get ahead of the next guy, and he did just that.
No score here as we play inning number two.
No.
And I believe they'll say he broke the plane, as yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. Runner staying tight to the bag at second. Here's the pitch. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. A couple of walks, but no damage. Through an inning and a half, no score on the show. Curtis Granderson will stand in now, and obviously one to be careful with, as you see there, currently leading the senior circuit in long balls. A fastball here as you'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. And there is the full list of home run leaders we alluded to a moment ago. The 1-0 home now to Granderson. And he lays off a fastball here that looked pretty good, but it's 2-0.
And this is all about handling a guy like this with kid gloves. You know, walk him if you have to, but don't let him be the one to beat you.
And a good comeback fastball there. It's two balls and a strike. Now the pitch. And this is fouled straight back. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. Waiting on deck is Ike Davis. And this is swung on and missed by Granderson, and that's the first out of the inning.
And this is where the scouting report really pays off. I mean, sometimes you just got to go looking for a soft spot in the guy's zone, and they found one there.
Ike Davis will stand in, and he wasn't much of a factor yesterday as he took an 0-for-4 in the loss. And he takes ball one.
Yeah, and when that pitch starts off outside, it's much easier to get a better view of it and then just lay off.
Bottom of the second here with no score. 1-0 on the way. And he goes the other way with a fastball as this is hit well out toward deep left field. Under it is Yelich, and there are two away now.
And you know, he's kind of going through a stretch right now where the ball just isn't jumping off his back. He's got a good pitch to hit right here. Looked like he put a good swing on it, but it just didn't go anywhere.
Juan Ligares will get his first chance now, trying to get something started with two away here in the bottom of the second.
Here we go.
Just off the outside, and it's 1-0.
That's what you have to do against a big sweeping slider like that. It starts in the zone, and it's probably going to finish out of the zone, so that's a good job just to lay off.
And here's his fastball for a called strike one, and he's hitting an even 90 on the gun.
Wow, he is spotting that fastball on a dime here early on.
Two out, nobody on. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a hard liner to center field. Bogusevic is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Mets go down 1-2-3. We'll move to the third with no score. Christian Yelich will dig in here. He singled to open up the ball game.
Left fielder, Christian Yelich.
Third inning underway now as a curveball misses here to start things out. It's 1-0. And maybe a little frustrated on the mound here as the fastball misses for ball two now.
Two really close pitches to kick off this at bat. Normally this guy would be all over him, but he's shown some discipline here with two good takes.
Now a swing and a ground ball, but a foul ball, and it's 2-1 now. Looks at a fastball inside, so he's in the driver's seat, 3-1.
Now this one sets up a big pitch because you don't want to lose that leadoff guy in a scoreless ballgame.
Ice cold soda available here, folks. Ice cold soda.
Ball hit high to the right side, but this will get into the seats, foul. Here's the full count offering. Now a changeup, and this is hit on the ground to shortstop. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
The batter, center fielder,
Brian Bogusevic will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. Here's the first pitch. And a ball, 1-0. Third inning, no score to this point. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Well, this is a guy up there that's not hitting a ton right now, but he can still work the count. And that alone can be beneficial to an offense.
On the way. And the third baseman will have a look at it, but this is back into the seats. Trying to shave that outside corner with the fastball, and he missed it. It's 3-1 now.
You figure he should get something good to hit here. They don't want to walk him and put him on for the heart of the order.
And a fastball misses there, ball four.
And you'd like to say, good job there, good eye. But in reality, nobody's swinging at that pitch. It's not even close.
Giancarlo Stanton will stand in. He grounded out his first time. First pitch coming. In tight here with the first pitch fastball. That's 1-0.
Well, this is a spot where it helps to have a two-seam fastball like that so you can work in on the right-handed hitters.
Breaking ball. That's in the dirt as he takes a ball.
And on 2-0, this is where he's the most dangerous up there. I know it's a fastball count, but I would maybe think about something else.
Go.
Pretty good cut there, but it's to 2-1 now. Is that really the spot you want to be messing with here?
Shouldn't be. That's a danger zone if you ask me.
Well hit, but also well fouled into the seats in left. The 2-2 coming. And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away.
That's a nice comeback from down in the count, 2-0. He doesn't panic. He doesn't just start laying pitches in there. He had a good plan to start with, and then he executed that plan all the way through the at-bat.
Garrett Jones will stride in again. He struck out swinging his first time. Now the first pitch. He's running towards second. Pitch misses low. The throw down is not in time as he just gets in ahead of the throw.
Well, they're trying to make something out of this inning after all. He's off and running here with two away, and he gets into second safely. So now all it'll take is a base hit to get us our first run of the game.
Two out here and a runner at second. Not close. It's 2-0. And now after the stolen base, how does that change the approach?
Well, you've got one out and a base open. You're already behind in the count. I don't think you have to challenge him here if you don't want to.
Here's the 2-0 pitch now to Jones. Now a ball grounded foul over toward the coaching box. One pitch is a fastball swung on and missed 2-2. And he's right on the fastball there as this is hit pretty well out towards deep left. And he'll pull this one down a step or two in front of the warning track, and the inning is over. A golden opportunity to get on the board. Here goes for naught. We've played 2.5, no score on the show. Omar Quintanilla will come forward to begin the inning. 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
And they're still searching for a base runner. It's been 6 up, 6 down to start the game.
Bottom three in the batting order here as the first pitch misses to the number 7 hitter. It's ball 1. Goes the other way, and this will kick off the third base bag. And who knows what might have happened if that ball not hit the bag, but this will go down as an infield single regardless.
You see here from above, since he's left-handed, he's got the third baseman playing well off the line. I don't know if this is exactly where he intended to hit the baseball, but it works out for him.
Travis d'Arnaud will dig in, and this season certainly hasn't been all that kind to him as he enters play with the average down in the 230s. And a fastball's in there for strike 1. And a fastball way off target here, and it's even at 1. Foul tip that's held onto with the plate, and the count moves to 1-2 now.
Now you got to beware of that sinker. I mean, he'd take a strikeout right now, but I think he still just wants this guy to hit the ball on the ground.
All right, grab it. Here we go.
And he reaches for one out of the zone and misses rather badly for the first out.
Being a number 8 hitter in the National League is really one of the toughest positions a guy can be in. You know, you've got your pitcher behind you on deck, so guys don't feel like they need to challenge you. You've got to be very disciplined up there. And that time,
He just wasn't.
Zach Wheeler will take a long look down here as he may be bunting to avoid the double play. Infield expecting bunt. Here's the first pitch. Pulls the bunt attempt back, but it's in there for strike one.
Oh, that's a good fastball right there, and you had to figure that he was looking for that sinker.
Showing bunt, but he winds up taking ball one.
Yeah, looked like he hit the target. That's a tough pitch to lay off, but he made it pan out.
And they'll try and play for one here as he gets this one down. Flip to the second baseman covering now for the out.
Yeah, this early in the game, to me, this is the right decision. You give that guy at the top of your lineup a chance to drive in a run with a simple base hit.
Eric Young Jr. will dig in again. He grounded out to start the home first. And this one's tapped foul at home plate. Now a swing and a chopper foul right at home plate. Runner not going anywhere at second. Now the pitch. Now a ball hit hard towards center. Dives and he makes the catch. How about that for an exclamation point to the end of the inning? Worth a second look here as this is a beauty to end the inning. We're back with more on a Sunday afternoon following this. Greg Dobbs will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth.
Baseman, Greg Dobbs.
First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. Fouled back. Here's Wheeler on 1-1. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1.
And you know, sometimes when you're thinking fastball, you try to get moving just a little bit early. And that's a good job of recognizing off speed and then holding back on the swing.
And a fastball swung on and hit in the air to left. He'll put it away without much trouble, and the leadoff man is retired here in the fourth. Jared Saltalamacchia will try it again. He flew out his first time. And a first pitch slider is right there for strike one. And this is going to be a foul ball. A ball hit hard to the left side. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Just the second hit they've got against him so far as we check on his numbers to this point. He's pretty much been in control all afternoon, so we'll see if he can keep that string of zeros going.
Adani Echevarria will try it again, set down on strikes his first time.
Strike him out.
And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. To first with it is Wheeler, and he'll dive back in.
Come on, guys, turn two!
Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1. And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
You talk about tying a guy up. My goodness.
Take it off. Let's get going.
A swing as he shoots this one over to the right side, and that'll find the big hole over there. It's a base hit. And the throw will come back in quickly, so it's first and second now with only one away.
Let's train our show motion camera on that runner at first base. Here, he might have had a shot to get around to third, but you see him have to hold up to make sure the baseball doesn't hit him. And by the time he gets going again, he knows he'll have to hold on at second base.
Jordani Valdespin is at the plate as he looks at ball one. Lays off a fastball that doesn't miss by much, and it's 2-0.
And one thing you can't do here, you cannot lose him and load the bases. He's still got a couple pitches to play with, but I'd expect this one to be somewhere in the strike zone.
Now both runners are breaking. Out in front of the fastball, but this is skied into straightaway right. Lagares will come in a bit and put it away for the second out of the inning. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now. Kevin Slowey will get a shot here with two on and two out here in the fourth. Not much of a lead at second. Now here's the pitch. A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one.
A lot of late movement on that fastball. That nearly came back to the outer edge.
And, oh, looked like ball two below the knees, but it's ruled a strike, and that evens the count at 1-1.
Oh, he's got a legitimate gripe right there. I don't know about that one.
Fastball close, but he didn't get it 2-1.
This guy is almost no threat up at the plate. I mean, you could get away with fastballs right down the middle if you wanted to.
Come on, man. 2-1. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. Lagares is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Marlins strand a pair. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Daniel Murphy will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth.
Second baseman, Daniel Murphy.
And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
Boy, his control has been outstanding so far. And there's another pitch right on the block.
And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
Yeah, that's a different pitch here, but also on the outside corner. Also taken for a strike. So he's got him in a quick 0-2 hole now.
And they'll try to tempt him with a curveball, but this bounces in front of the plate, and it's 1-2. And a half swing that time, but it's a full swing in the eyes of the umpire, and that'll be the first out of the inning.
Well, let's take a look at this check swing here in show motion. From this speed, it almost always looks like the guy goes around. Here? Well, it looked like a good call down there at third base. I think that bat did break the plane, and that is a strike.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And stepping in, the all-star third baseman, David Wright. Now a swing as he shoots this down the right field line. And this will be off the wall out near the 330 marker. The throw into second. And he will beat the throw into second as he slides in safely with a one-out double.
Pretty fortunate he was able to keep this ball fair. This is pretty close down the line. You see it winding up, one hopping the wall down there, and that allows him to cruise into second with two bases.
Curtis Granderson will stride in again. He struck out swinging his first time. On the corner at the knees, 0-1. Well, for Wright, that's now 14 doubles on the season so far. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Rolled softly down the line, and that is a foul ball. Off of second is Wright. Now the pitch. Chopper, foul. Pitch in the dirt, swung on and missed for strike three as they'll need to throw to first here. And indeed, the throw will finish him off as they get the put out at first, and there are two away now.
Yeah, and that turns out to be a nice little play there behind the plate. They get the swing through for strike three, but then he's got to get the out over there at first base and make sure that nobody else advances. And he's able to accomplish both of those tasks.
Fastball here as this is slashed the other way over the third baseman's head. A fair ball. He'll get it into second. But he'll get in there with an RBI double.
Well, time for another old baseball cliche. It's a game of inches. And it was on this ball. Take a look at how close this is to the foul line. This is not a fair ball by a whole lot, but I guarantee you he'll take it. He pulls into second with an RBI double.
Juan Ligares will stand in, a line-out victim his first time. Watches a fastball right there for strike one. For Davis, he's at second with his 18th double of the year. Close to the bag at second there. Now the pitch. Hit hard to the right side. Foul. Now a hard hit ball back up the middle. And that's through into center field. Base hit. Now a long throw home. And the run's going to come into score from second as they grab a 2-0 lead now. And time will be called here as the pitching coach heads out to the mound and hopefully try and settle this guy down a bit. Oh, Omar Quintanilla will try and keep things going now with a runner at first following the RBI single. First pitch coming. And this is fouled back and out of play. Two runs, four hits, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. Ligaris runs. Pitch is a called strike. The throw, not in time. He's in there at second.
Well, they've got two on the board here in the inning, but you can see that they're not content just yet. Good job there to steal second safely, and now a two-out single could make this a three-run inning.
Runner holding tight at second, now the pitch. Had him lunging for that one as he sends a little ground ball out in front of the mound. He had a close play at first, but he's called out and the side is retired. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors and a runner left on. We played four full, Mets out in front, 2-0. Christian Yelich will stand in to start things off as this top of the batting order hasn't found a whole lot of success so far.
In fact, just one hit between the 1-2-3 hitters combined. So apparently the table setters have not been getting their chores done.
Here's the first offering. And here's a fastball called for strike one. And that's inside off the plate with the fastball. It's one and one. Called strike in a dangerous location there, one and two.
Seems like it's been a fairly consistent pattern. Hard stuff early, soft stuff late. But these guys don't seem to have caught on yet.
It's a pretty standard operating procedure, too. But they just look lost up there.
To two balls and two strikes now. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Oh, and he's caught looking at a beautiful curveball there as that buckled him for the first out of the inning.
I'll tell you what, he's throwing with a lot of confidence right now. And he's also taking some chances with location, but you know, he's thinking he's bulletproof out there, and so far he has been.
Brian Bogusevic will stand in, base on balls his last time. And this is hit hard on the ground at first. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now.
Well, I think he got away with one right there. I mean, this is a fastball right down the middle. And he just smokes this ball, too. But unfortunately, he hits it right at someone. So it becomes a fairly easy out.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And set to stand in the ultra-dangerous Giancarlo Stanton. First pitch to him. There's a good fastball on the outside corner as he'll take a look at strike one.
Yeah, the best way to neutralize this guy's power, just keep putting pitches right there.
That's in there as well. It's a quick 0-2 count.
He's closing in on putting up yet another zero.
No runs, three hits, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. and a wasted pitch there, 1-2.
Could be that high fastball there was just a setup pitch. Now you've kind of established that high sight level. Could be a good time to break off a nasty curveball.
And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. Lined hard to center field. And that's in there. Base hit.
Yeah, a nice job there to get on base with a two-out single. When you're facing a guy that's getting up there in pitches, this can be important because instead of being out of the inning, if he's forced to make 10 pitches or so after this, he might be out of this game.
Garrett Jones will stand in now. He's struck out and flied out 0-for-2 thus far. Fastball in there for a called strike.
And now you got to regroup after the two-out single. You're in a dangerous spot in the lineup, so the inning's not over yet, not by a long shot.
Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1. Hits are now even at 4 apiece. Now a swing and a fly ball hit fairly well out to deep center field. Young will get there and he puts it away to retire the side. Marlins leave one. They trail things here 2-0. Travis d'Arnaud will stand in to lead things off in the bottom of the fifth. And this is going to be a foul ball. That misses. One ball and one strike here to the Mets backstop. And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Got in his kitchen big time right there.
Hit on the ground towards first. And he'll take this to the bag, 3 unassisted for the first out.
And there's a look at his pitch count so far. You can see he's already thrown 37 pitches for strikes. That shows me that he's been able to work the zone effectively to this point.
Zach Wheeler will dig in. No official at-bat yet as he delivered a sacrifice bunt in his first appearance. Grounded fouled off to the right side. Swing and a ball lifted into straightaway center. Bogusevic is there now, and he has it, 2 gone.
Yeah, he's able to set down his opposite number there, and I'll tell you, these two guys have pretty much matched each other pitch for pitch so far.
Eric Young Jr. will stand in 0-for-2 in the ball game so far. Here's the first offering. And this ball will be chopped foul. And that finds the target. Nothing in 2 now.
Come on, Matt.
can't quite get the low outside corner there. It's one and two. Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Mets, as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Greg Dobbs will stand in to lead things off as the Marlins look to get things started here in their half of the sixth. And it looks now like a right-hander's begun to get loose in the Mets bullpen. Up and away to start the inning, it's 1-0.
Well, one thing we've seen from this guy on the mound so far, when he makes bad pitches, they typically miss out of the strike zone. They don't miss in the zone where they can be crushed.
Ball two.
Now he's going to get a visit from his catcher just to make sure he's all right. But you know, this might actually be more of a stall tactic here. I mean, his pitch count, it's starting to get up there. So this might just be to buy a little time for that bullpen.
Two-0 count, the pitch. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. Lined hard towards short. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
Yeah, and it's kind of been one of those days. There haven't been too many balls hit hard. And even when they do hit one hard, it's an atom ball.
Jared Saltalamacchia will come forward now. He has flied out and singled so far. And a fastball is in there for strike one. He continues to get ahead here. He's been in complete control.
I think you need to guard yourself from being overconfident, though. A bloop and a blast could still turn this game on its ear.
Go.
Having success with the fastball here, it's 0-2 now. I'll tell you, he's been living on that corner all the afternoon.
And you can tell, guys at the plate, they're starting to get frustrated. He just hasn't made many mistakes at all. And when he has, they've been out of the zone.
Tried to get him out front, but it's a ball 1-2.
Good changeup right there, down in the strike zone. Definitely the one they wanted to strike him out on, so that's a great job to lay off.
One out, nobody on. 1-2. And he lays off the fastball away, so it's 2-2 now.
And when he's down 0-2, he's smart enough to know guys are going to try and get him to chase. So now at 2-2, he's got himself back to a spot where he doesn't have to go after a pitcher's pitch.
And here is strike three called on the fastball. To be about eye level, but it's out number two instead.
You know, and I think most hitters will tell you, if you get a bad call on strike one or strike two, you know, they can live with that. But if you're going to punch me out on strike three, it better be a strike. If not, I feel like you're taking the bat out of my hands.
Adany Echevarria will stand in. A strikeout victim his first time and then a base hit last time around. Trying to jam him with the first pitch slider, but it's in a bit too tight for ball one. I know we have a tendency in the media to get hung up on pitch counts, but this is a legitimate workload he's sweated through so far.
Yeah, anytime you get up around that 110 mark, you put in a full shift, and he's fast approaching it here.
And he swings under the curveball here as this is lifted to shallow center field. Young is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Marlins. They're still down. It's 2-0. Daniel Murphy. We'll dig in now as he'll lead things off for the Mets in their half of the sixth. Marlins have some action in the bullpen now as a right-hander is up and throwing. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. First two pitches off the mark here. It's 2-0.
Well, you know, things have gone his way more often than not so far this afternoon, but he certainly didn't get any help on that one.
Here we go. 3-0 now.
And that questionable call on the previous pitch, it really changes the at-bat because he doesn't want to just lay one in there on 2-0. Now it's 3-0, and the tide is not working in his favor.
And a good comeback there. It's 3-1. That's in there, and it'll run the count to full, 3-2.
Boy, if he can get him right here, coming back from 3-0, what a way to start the inning that would be.
Now a swing and a high fly ball, and this one has some carry on it to deep right field. And this is taken in just shy of the warning track for out number one.
Get a look there at his pitch breakdown so far. Well, that sinker of his is a great weapon to have, and he picked the right spot to use it there.
David Wright will dig in, 1-for-2 to this point in the ball game. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one.
And even though he's pitching well, this is a part of the order that he's really got to worry about. Now they can turn a good outing into a bad one pretty darn quickly.
The next pitch. And he misses again, 2-0.
Yeah, a little unlucky here to be behind 2-0. Those first couple of pitches haven't missed by a whole lot.
Fouled back. And a sinker sinks too much there as it bounces into the catcher's glove.
And he's got a little bit of work to do now to avoid that first walk.
The 3-1 coming. And the good fastball there finds the zone as the count goes full now, 3-2.
That's a borderline strike right there, and I think that he had one step out of the batter's box headed towards first already.
Come on, Mike. Here we go. Now a ball hit high in the air and deep down the line in left. And this had home run distance, but it just does hook foul. Awfully close there on 3-2, but take your base, says Earl Hendricks. It's ball four.
Hey, you know what? That's all right. He gave him a pretty good battle up there, and he never gave in to him. A walk you can work around. A home run, you can't.
Curtis Granderson will try again. Struck out swinging his last time through. Catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing in one.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got two strikeouts already, but he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
What was that?
Now a swing and a miss there from Granderson, and he's quickly down here 0-2.
And this is part of the reason why he's staring a hat trick right in the face. He just hasn't been able to recognize these pitches that are well out of the zone.
Goes the other way as this is lined to left, but pretty much right at the left fielder as he takes it in for the second out.
You know, this is an easy ball to misjudge, especially off a left-hander's bat because of the spin. But he stays right with this play, and he makes it look pretty routine.
Ike Davis will dig in. He doubled home a run last time around. First offering on the way. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. This is foul for the first strike. That's on the inside corner to put him behind here. Nothing in two. For that man right there, you need look back only to his last start to see a performance like the one he's shown here so far.
And well on his way to another great outing. And that's what you get when you mix your speeds and throw a lot of strikes.
Now a swing by Davis and a ground ball out to second. Throw on to first gets him and the side is retired. Mets leave one. They're up 2-0. Welcome back to Citi Field in Flushing. Getting set for the seventh inning now with the Mets out on top. But first, let's check out the game summary through the first six innings of baseball. Jordani Valdespin will stand in here to start the seventh. EK, it's been a pitching and defense afternoon all throughout.
Yeah, neither starter looking like he's ready to blink. And neither one of them looking all that tired just yet.
Too high that time with the inning's first pitch. It's ball one. Action in the Mets bullpen now. It's both a lefty and a right-hander that start to throw. Here's a swing and a ground ball. Over to first now is Davis as he takes it himself for the out. Rob Brantley will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. And this is fouled back and out of play. That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Now here it comes. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. An easy take there, and it's 3-1 now.
Well, I think it's time to attack now because these guys haven't been in too many good hitters' counts. This is where you need to pounce.
And this is lined into left field, and a welcome to the ball game there as he's got himself a pinch hit single.
Oh, that's just a nice play out there in the corner. You know, with most guys, this is a sure double, but he might even have hit this ball a little too hard because they can get it back into the infield quickly, and that's going to hold him to just a single.
Christian Yelich will dig in now, and he'll do so representing the tying run.
Yeah, and you're not too worried about this guy jumping the yard on you here and tying the ball game. But if he does find a way to get on base, things get a whole lot more interesting.
Ball one. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. Runners on first with one down. That missed close. It's ball two.
Well, if he's missing right here, he ain't missing by much. Not getting too many favors behind the plate.
That one's more like it, he says. Back to 2-1 now.
And at the plate, if you've got an umpire helping you out, no reason to go after a borderline pitch on 2-0.
The 2-1 home. Now a swing and a ground ball. The second for one. On to Davis, but they won't get two as he beats out the back end.
Yeah, just a lot of English on that ball down there at third, and I think he might have taken an extra split second to make sure he had a grip on that thing, and that's all that was needed to ensure that they were only going to get one out instead of two.
Brian Bogusevic will stand in for the fourth time now, still looking for his first hit of the ball game.
And he's not the only one either. This has been a great pitching performance so far, and they've had these guys chasing their tails all game long.
First pitch coming, and they'll start things out with a changeup here, but this is a bit too tight. It's ball one.
Going wide.
Runners on the move for second. And, oh, this one's by him to the backstop. And no throw, as it turns out, as he takes second with ease.
With two outs, this is a great time to try it. I mean, hey, get into scoring position and give this guy a chance to bring you in with just a simple base hit.
Runner staying tight to the bag at second. Here's the pitch. And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1. For Yelich, that's stolen base number 6 now on the year. And a strike on the fastball. So from 2-0, it's 2-2 now.
Yeah, he's definitely still bringing it. It's the seventh inning, and we're still hearing the catcher's mitt snapping all the way up here.
Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Here now the 2-2. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. One left for Miami. They're down 2-0. So a new pitcher set to come on now, as it'll be the effectively wild Carlos Marmol that makes an appearance here. Juan Ligares will step in now to lead off the home half of the seventh. And just lucky to make contact on that one, as it's chopped foul. Now the 0-1 is swung on and lifted out to straightaway center field. Bogusevic is right there, one down.
Now batting, shortstop, Omar Quintanilla.
Omar Quintanilla will dig in here. One for two. He's singled and grounded out so far. Now here's the first pitch. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Slider, but that's low as it's dug out by the catcher there.
And the one thing this guy will do, he won't give away at-bats. He may not be the most talented guy on the field, but he'll grind you up there.
Here's the 2-0. Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0. Pitching him pretty careful here, wouldn't you say?
Well, it's possible to be too careful. I mean, this is not a Silver Slugger Award winner up there. You want this guy to hit the ball and put it in play.
Taking all the way, and it's 3-1 now.
And at the plate, he might have been told, look, you're taken until you get a strike. It's not a bad idea.
Bases are empty, one man out. Here comes the 3-1. And this is swung on and sent on the ground to first. Over to first is Jones as he'll step on the bag to record the putout. Travis d'Arnaud will dig in for the third time now. He struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. And, oh, looked inside, but that's ruled a strike, nothing in one.
When he's got that slider working the way he wants it, it can be such a weapon for him.
Outside at 94, one ball and one strike. Down low, two balls and a strike.
Grab it! All right, man.
Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. The 2-2. And he reaches for one but can't find it as he's down on strikes for the final out. Mets go down 1-2-3, but they're on top 2-0. Giancarlo Stanton will get us going now in the top half of the eighth.
Right fielder, Giancarlo Stanton.
On to the eighth here as a slider is taken to begin the at-bat. It's ball one. Well, that man right there is into his eighth inning of work now. Any concerns going forward?
Well, I think the only thing you have to worry about is that pitch count you see right there. Other than that, he's earned the right to stay out there. Usually the other team will tell you when you're starting to get tired.
On to first, and that's an important first out to start the eighth here.
Yeah, he just keeps rolling right along. Shut out intact as you get a look at his line so far. Through 7 1/3 innings now, they have just not been able to mount any type of offense against him at all.
Garrett Jones will stand in now, hoping to get on track as they've been able to neutralize his power out of the cleanup spot. 0-for-3 thus far. And a curveball drops in there for strike one.
You have to say they've really had a good game plan for attacking the 3-4-5 hitters all game long.
Yeah, and I think the only thing that's better than a game plan has been the execution of that game plan. You're exactly right. They've held this lineup at bay.
Now a ball grounded foul over toward the coaching box. And this is going to be a foul ball. Oh, now this is hit hard to the right side, but caught out there at second base. And the shift works out perfectly. Two away now.
Well, it's been a game of starting pitching so far, as on cue we give you a look at our starter comparison for these two guys in our 2-0 ball game.
Greg Dobbs come in now with two away, and to this point at least, so much for having the 3-4-5 guys get the rally started.
Yeah, it's been an important inning for that man out there on the mound. He's held his ground, and he may get through the teeth of this lineup, still holding on to that lead.
Here's the first pitch to him. Checks his swing, but this pitch is right there for strike one.
And maybe that's off the black just a little bit, but when you're around the plate as much as he's been, you're going to find that you're going to get a few calls like that.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Good job of holding up on the low ball there, and it's 1-2.
Well, that's a smart miss there. They know he'll chase it down there, so even if it didn't get the job done, it's a great pitch on 0-2.
And it's to 2-2 now with the bases empty and two gone here in the inning. A swing and a ball popped in the air back behind short. Quintanilla is underneath this one, and that will retire the side. Miami down in order. They trail it here 2-0. Kirk Nieuwenhuis is going to grab a bat here as he looks to try to set the table in the bottom of the eighth as they look for some insurance. And that misses for ball one. Fires in a strike this time to make it 1-1.
Yeah, there's a good one right there, right over the top. Just fire that thing in there.
A little bit outside, 2-1. Now he'll try to bunt his way on, but this is popped up. And the move to the pinch hitter will not pan out as that's taken in for the first out. Very brisk pace to the ball game thus far. 2-0 our score as you get a look there at the line score to this point in the contest. Eric Young Jr. will stand in, and they've done a good job keeping him off base at the top of the lineup. He's 0 for 3 thus far. Now a late square, and this is popped up, but a foul ball here, 0-1. Now a late bunt attempt here, but he misses strike two. Foul toward the third base dugout, but this will get back into the seats out of play. Another 0-2 coming. And a half-hearted attempt that time, but they'll say he broke the plane. And that's out number two.
The batter number 28, second baseman.
You know, it seems like every time we check these out and show motion, it always looks like the bat breaks the plane. Look here, sure enough, I don't think he holds up in time. Looked to me like that was the right call.
Daniel Murphy will try again, 0 for 3 thus far. Lays off 1-0.
Sometimes all it takes is just one call to go against you, like that one right there, and then you get yourself out of your own rhythm. You got to be able to put that behind you and move on.
This one's a strike. It's 1-1. Really a good job so far by this guy out of the bullpen.
Yeah, he's come in and really put his stamp on this game. He's thrown a lot of strikes. That's what you want.
Two out, nobody on. Slider clocked in the mid-80s there. It's a ball and two strikes.
Very patient here to start the at-bat. Maybe even a little too patient, because now he's down 1-2.
Yeah, and I don't think he's going to get anything better than that to hit.
Here comes a 1-2. Just inside, not by much. It's 2-2.
And even with two outs, this is a team that can still put something together here, especially in this part of the lineup. So you can't let your guard down.
Started to go. They'll look for the appeal down to third and ring him up, says the third base umpire. He's gone. Down in order go the Mets as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Bobby Parnell is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth. Jared Saltalamacchia will be tasked now with leading things off in their half of the ninth, as they'll try to do something to prevent being shut out.
And whatever they've done for the first eight innings hasn't yielded a whole lot so far, so quite frankly, I'm not expecting too much.
Action in the Mets bullpen now. It's both a lefty and a right-hander that start to throw. Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a cold strike.
And here's where you don't need to be an RBI guy. You don't need to be a home run guy. You have to be a leadoff guy. Just get on base somehow to give that tying run on deck a shot.
Now a knuckler hit on the ground to second. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
That's a nice backhanded play there at second. You'd like to be able to get in front of this ball if you can, but here he does a nice job of looking it into the glove, and then he makes the throw to first for the out.
Adani Echevarria will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs. Now the first pitch changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike.
That thing's coming in there hot, 96 miles an hour.
One one on the way. Had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2.
And if you're going to go after that pitch, you've got to be thinking right field. I think he just pulled off of that one a little.
Tried to shoot the corner, and he missed it. 2-2. One out, nobody on. Looks at a fastball low here, and it's full, 3-2.
Now, 3-2 with a two-run lead. This has to be in the strike zone. You can't work the corner here. This has to be right at it.
He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Well, this is a stroll he's taken five times in this series now. That slow walk back to the dugout after getting punched out. After a while, these things, they start to wear on you. Got to try to keep the mindset that every at-bat's a new opportunity, but most of the time, that's easier said than done.
Jordani Valdespin will stand in as their last chance now. Now a ball hit foul down the line in right and in amongst the fans. On a swing, and he popped him up off to the left in foul territory. And he'll put this one away for the final out, and the Mets will salvage at least the finale in this three-game series as the ball game is over.
Well, it's always nice to end the first half in style and get that final win in your pocket before the break. Now, most of these guys can take a few days off to heal their wounds before the second half kicks off later in the week.
One final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. Well, you always hope to get a good outing from your starting pitcher, but this man went above and beyond in this one. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he wound up turning things over to his bullpen in the ninth, but still, eight strong innings for him. He was hitting his spots all game long.
So that'll just about do it. For Eric Caro, Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshownation.com. The Mets come out on top, 2-0. So long from New York.